Welcome to Not Entirely Unlike Tea with Christine Collins. Hey there, it's Christine Collins, and I recently got into a conversation around morning routines and the importance of the impact that can have on your mindset throughout your entire day. And one of the things that came out of doing all of that decluttering that we talked about in some of the previous episodes is the recognition that in order to have a tidy space, whether it's virtually, mentally, or physically, it requires upkeep, regular investment of time and energy into keeping those spaces in good condition, and that includes your mindset. So it's not one of those one and done things where you clean up your house one time and it always just stays that way. Mindset is very similar. We have to have little routines, habits, and rituals that keep us on a positive vibe. It's those daily choices. What are we consuming today? What are we listening to? What media are we taking in? What are we reading? And then your thoughts. What are we actually thinking about, focusing on, and drawing our attention towards? And that got me a little bit reflective about morning routines and how important it can be what you do the first few minutes of your day. And I always like to preface that conversation with the understanding that everyone has different life situations, and it just isn't always possible for people to meditate faithfully every morning. There may be family obligations, work obligations, and other types of things. So I always like to start by saying that it's never coming from a judgmental place. There's always an understanding that we all have different life situations and lifestyles, and some of us are at different places in life where those things aren't possible. Instead of offering a prescription or something highly specific, I simply invite you to consider what things might work for you and really allowing yourself to be as creative as possible, even as I'm sharing things that I do. That doesn't mean that it works and slides in perfectly into your world, but maybe there are modifications and alternative ways that you could incorporate certain things into your own experience. So that internal weather that we have is very much influenced by small choices that we make each day. Often we make them on autopilot, subconsciously. We've just always done it that certain way. Maybe we're mirroring what we were raised with or what we've seen other people do. It's simply a societal norm or standard. This is how everybody does it. And again, a gentle invitation to question those things, because just because everyone you know does sleep a certain way or does diet and nutrition a certain way or their morning routine a certain way, that doesn't mean that's what works for you. And the older I get, the more I recognize the importance of customization for those habits and rituals, because we are all different. And our moods and emotions shift a lot in response to things like hormones and stage of life and life circumstance and diet and sleep and the interactions that we're having in our lives. And it's also highly influenced by whether we allow our internal mindset to get cluttered and messy and feeling yuck in terms of our thought processes. And we can manage that mindset with routines and habits that are repeatable. We can get those things onto autopilot so that they become the new norm. And that can go a very long way in keeping that inner landscape feeling good. So one thing that I was sort of forced into implementing due to circumstances, but have very much been grateful for making that shift, was that several years ago, I had to make a change in my morning rituals. And the reason for that was because I had a lot of changes in my life all at one time. This was roughly, say, 8 or so years ago. And a lot of things kind of went down for me within a very short period of time. I lost a parent, my employment situation changed dramatically, my health situation changed dramatically, and my family situation changed dramatically all at once. And part of some of those changes included some incredibly deeply toxic and damaging interactions that we were having with particular people, staying very vague there, but it had a tremendously negative impact on my health, my emotional health, and my well-being. And I was still in a habit that had been formed through my corporate years of waking up and first thing in the morning, grabbing my phone, checking email, getting head deep straight into emails, text messages, you know, whatever was coming in and whatever was going on. And because I had formed that habit during my years working in a corporate environment where it felt like it was part of my role at that time, I always had my head in what was going on, but more importantly, I always had it first thing. Like before I had even gotten out of bed, had something to eat, you know, done really much of anything to take care of myself, I was automatically scooped up into whatever drama was happening with other people and other situations. And because of some of these personal matters that were going on at that time for me with all of these different transitions, I was exposed to some incredibly toxic things that started coming at me first thing in my morning. And it was very damaging for me emotionally. And so because of that, I recognized that I needed to make a change in several things, but most importantly, in what I was doing first thing. I could no longer have a situation where I wasn't even out of bed yet and I'm already reading emails because it was incredibly unhealthy for me. And so that led me to make some big changes in my routines and in my mindset practices, because this was, you know, like I said, it was several years ago. So I was just beginning my journey of better understanding our psychology and our mindset and the incredible power that those things have in our life experience. And so it led me to begin a practice of the first 15 minutes of my day, every day, being for me in some way, usually with some form of meditation, which eventually became hypnosis over time as I was beginning to study and develop my certifications, becoming a master certified hypnotherapist, which I am today. Eventually, those tools became tools that I was creating, and having a daily morning mindset ritual for 10 or 15 minutes before I even touched emails and text messages and that sort of thing made a huge difference for me. And I don't want to sound dramatic, but it really did change everything for me. And so it dawned on me that this might be helpful and useful for someone else if you don't yet have a practice like that for yourself. Some of the small steps that I took in order to make that realistic, right? Because this was a process, it didn't just all happen easily right away. I had to kind of trial and error different ways of doing this. So the first thing that I started doing was using either a do not disturb or an airplane mode in the beginning of my day. And I also recognize that for many people, they need to be able to have an open line of communication with particular family members or small children or elderly family, whatever that case may look like for you. And so again, inviting creativity with how you set that up for yourself and having arrangements or agreements within your household and that sort of thing to not be disturbed, perhaps, if that's an option for you during those first 10 or 15 minutes. You can also create things in your phone, like rules, where only certain phone numbers can break through. So that is definitely an option that I recommend. That way, if a phone call comes in, it truly is urgent from someone that needs to actually reach you versus a spam phone call, perhaps disrupting your meditation time. So there are some things you can set up in your phone. That was one of them that I did, is making decisions about things like airplane mode, do not disturb mode, having rules within my phone that only certain people could reach me during those moments. Nowadays, I stay in do not disturb most of the time, and only those same specific people can actually break through. Additionally, depending on the type of phone that you use, most of the time you can edit the home screen and move the different apps and things like that around. So if you have your email button or your social media stuff, whatever things you may have on your phone, what I did is I put all of those things together in a separate screen, and my primary screen, like the default screen that I would see when I would open my phone, was only my meditation or hypnosis stuff. nothing else. There were no email buttons. I could not see notifications for anything else, social media, text messages, nothing. All of that was on a totally different screen. It was turned off in one way or another through some of these different settings and options that you may have. And so the only thing that I could see when I would grab my phone first thing in the morning for that first 10 or 15 minutes is whatever tool I was using for my mindset ritual. And it does require a little bit of practice and self-discipline to create the habit of not going and looking. So that was probably the first thing that was a little bit challenging for me, because it had been such a natural thing for me to dive right into my email. So even after I moved it to the other screen, at least initially, there would still be that temptation to scroll over and find those apps. But eventually, with dedication and also the very clear recognition that I really didn't even want to do that anymore because it was harming me, I made the decision every morning to just stay with that main screen that just had the meditation or hypnosis on it. And over time, it becomes very natural. And that's just the way that it becomes. Like, that's the default now. And a little side item there in terms of what you're looking at specifically while still laying in bed is that there's a lot of material out there that suggests the detrimental impact of having a negative association of while you're in your bed, which is why, for example, it's recommended that if you're having trouble sleeping or you're feeling anxious or stressed, that you perhaps get up and maybe go sit in a chair and read a book or do something somewhere else so that your bed becomes associated with the positive, relaxing feelings. And so looking at negative things while you're laying in your bed is actually really detrimental for your sleep hygiene. So that was another element that I learned that I found to be very helpful for me. So I began this practice of 10 to 15 minutes. Some mornings it may be shorter and some it may be longer. It really depends on what you maybe have going on that day. I know for myself, just being transparent, there have been plenty of times when I've woken up a little bit later or I had somewhere I had to go, and sometimes that routine would get disrupted a little bit. Like, I'd be listening to my meditation while I'm actually getting up and, you know, washing my face and that sort of thing. But for the most part, I honored and protected that time, those first 10 to 15 minutes, by laying there and doing a meditation practice or listening to a hypnosis audio. And there's a variety of lengths of different things. That's one of the reasons why in my hypnosis membership, I include different lengths. I have some things that are 5 minutes and 8 minutes. I have other things that are longer, 15 minutes, 18 minutes. So there's a variety of options depending on how much time you realistically have for yourself. It might seem like 5 minutes won't be enough to make an impact, but you would be surprised at how differently you can feel by spending just those few minutes doing something for yourself, doing something that promotes your mindset and your well-being, as opposed to just jumping out of bed or looking at something that could be upsetting or stressful. So as I began to do this new practice, the first thing that I started to notice was that feeling of kind of inner dread that had built up in me from receiving some of these emails and things that were going on, it began to dissipate. I started to feel more relaxed when I first woke up. I also started to feel more cared for because I was actually looking after myself instead of allowing other people and outside things to dictate how I was going to feel first thing in the morning. Now, granted, at some point, you maybe still have to go and look at that email or that text or whatever it is, but by the time you do, you are in a different headspace. And I think that it sends a very, very strong message subconsciously to yourself that you have put yourself first in that way. You have taken care of your needs first before attending to what someone else needs, particularly if those someone else's are not necessarily having your best interest at heart in those cases. And I started to understand better that while it was very easy to blame outside things for causing me stress, at the same time, I could make choices that were different. And that essentially I was allowing that to happen. I was allowing those negative messages to hit me first thing in the morning. I had not set boundaries that I needed to have in order to protect myself emotionally, and more importantly, to just manage my own mindset and how I was going into my day. And after a little while of doing this, I noticed that I felt less resentful, less frustrated and stressed. I felt more energized and more eager to get into my day, because instead of letting someone else's needs and demands and agenda influence the first thing that I was doing, I was taking those 10 or 15 minutes or however long I had and setting my own agenda for my own day, deciding which things mattered to me for that day, which things I wanted to focus on. And the impact of other people's things was reduced and got smaller and smaller and smaller over time as I continued this practice. Being just that little bit of selfish to look after yourself, the funny thing about doing that is that it actually makes you a better person to deal with others. It actually puts you into a position where your interactions, like you're bringing your best self now to the table instead of bringing in your stressed out, unhappy, resentful, angry, irritated, tired self. You're bringing a better version of you into every interaction that you're having. So doing certain things that may seem selfish on the surface protect you, but they also protect other people as well. And having those moments to visualize my game plan, I had just started in my business, it was in the very early stages, and allowing me to think through what my goals were and what were the things that I needed to focus on to drive my business forward. Having those boundaries set, creating an understanding that I had my own back, and that regardless of what someone else may be throwing at me in this situation or that, I was taking care of myself first, focusing my energy where it was most deserved, which was towards my goals and my wishes and the things that I wanted to do. And it gave me back more of a sense of agency and control over things, getting that little bit of time to myself first thing in the day. It allowed me to make better decisions about how to enter into various types of interactions rather than stumbling into them while I was still, you know, very out of it or sleepy or not quite awake yet for the day and unprepared. And then as I incorporated hypnosis specifically into this morning mindset routine, in addition to just getting that little dash of me time, which was so precious and so useful, the hypnosis itself is transformational, where I could begin to shift and change some of the beliefs that may have been stopping me from pursuing my success, from feeling confident, from feeling like I could believe in myself, like I could believe in my business, like I could have hope and optimism to move forward with things. So the hypnosis audios themselves have a transformational quality that goes above and beyond just being a nice little relaxing meditative experience. So it's kind of like the best of both worlds, really. And those things have now become a non-negotiable for me. And because of many years of doing it that way, it's now just very much second nature. I don't have to think about it anymore. So again, it's just an invitation of possibilities, really, to consider if there are any small changes, and it doesn't have to be a big dramatic change for it to make a big difference. You would be surprised at how much of a difference just a few minutes can make. And if you are in a position where you're thinking about trying a mindset tool or a mindset ritual like that, I do offer hypnosis audios, as you probably know by now. I have a hypnosis membership that's only a few dollars a month. All those details are there in the show notes if you'd like to check it out. And until we connect the next time, I wish you the most magical and creative rest of your day. Thanks for listening. This is Christine Collins at transformcreate.com.